Thank you. So we start with the English class. Today, we are going to review the page 121. So you can watch. We start with the unit 10. The topic is small talk. And so, get it started. Tenemos aquí entonces ya la unidad 10, chicos. Nos estamos acercando pues al final pues estas son las últimas unidades. Y en este caso pues vamos a hablar acerca de los diálogos cortos, ¿no? Small talk, una conversación corta. Y puede ver ahí usted en su libro y en la pantalla pues las imágenes, ¿no? De personas que se están conociendo, ¿no? Que están entablando tal vez su primer diálogo, apenas están ellos mirando, no sé, en algún lugar, tal vez aquí en la universidad, en el colegio. ¿Sí? Y pues de eso va a tratar el tema de esta unidad. Now, we have first to read the Get It Started. And please, Ismael, can you tell me the reading?
Get it started. Are you nervous when you meet someone new? How do you initiate a conversation? Sometimes knowing what not to say is an important aside in the writing. Are you prepared for meeting people from different cultures?
Thank you. So we have the Get It Started and some questions about this unit, the topic of this unit. Tenemos entonces aquí, chicos, unas preguntas que, bueno, luego podrán responderlas. Ahora lo que nos vamos a concentrar es en continuar con el ejercicio del libro. So, in the page 122, we have the break the ice. Rompiendo el hielo. The first exercise is the task number one. Listen to the audio, check the tips that are being discussed. Aquí entonces, como podrán ver, ustedes tienen el primer ejercicio, rompiendo el hielo. Escuche el audio. Y pues ponga un visto en los tips que están siendo discutidos, ¿no? O que están siendo tomados en cuenta en el audio. Pongan atención en esta parte, por favor, porque nos va a hablar acerca de 7 tips de cómo ser un maestro en el arte de las conversaciones cortas, ¿no? Small talk. So, 7 tips for mastering the art of small talk. Number one, please, Andrés Burgos, read it.
Keep up with current events. Exchange perspectives on world news. People love showing off their knowledge to an audience.
Thank you. Dice que se mantenga, ¿no? En los eventos actuales, o sea que hay que hablar de eventos actuales y pues mostrar a la gente de que tú tienes conocimiento, ¿no? De lo que estás hablando. Number two, David, please read.
Bring up athletic competitions, chatter about ball games and your favorite team.
Athletic competition, that is the second tip. Number three, Kimi Luis.
Discuss pop culture, share thoughts about a popular TV series you are watching, say where you live.
Okay, number three, pop culture, TV series, popular TV series, and that's all, folks. Number four, Cáceres María.
Be all ears, listen to what the other person has to say. People are interesting.
Okay, be all ears. What is the meaning for this sentence? Be all ears. Maria, do you know what is the meaning for be all ears?
Que es todo oídos.
Sean todo oídos, ¿no? Ser todo oídos. Escucha lo que la otra persona tiene que decir. Eso también es clave, ¿no? Para mantener estas conversaciones. Number five, Steven Mora. Read, please.
Sharon, I'm getting about your day. Did you lose your phone? I've been $12. People are intrigued by a personal story.
People are intrigued by a personal story. No, share an anecdote. That is important in a small talk when you meet with something. Number six, Lopez John Jairo.
Think about another you meet recently. Who knows you could score a little book.
Thank you. Talk about a novel, novela, no? Discover a book lover. You must try to speak when you are going to read some book about a topic specific. Number seven, Cárdenas Ismael.
Sugar's fine restaurants. Chat about the cuisine you like or the coffee that serves the best coffee.
Fine restaurants. That is another topic when you a small talk. Entonces aquí tenemos pues un. Espérenme un momentito que está sonando. ¿No está haciendo interferencia ahí algo? ¿No escucho nada extraño? No. Ahí me parece. Bien, en este último punto tenemos algo importante que señalar. Aquí tiene la palabra café y coffee. ¿Cuál es la diferencia entre estas dos? García Anthony. Tiene aquí la palabra café y coffee. No te escuché.
No, es que yo nunca lo escuché.
¿Cuál es la diferencia entre café y coffee? A ver, Steven Mora, sí, no te escucho muy bien.
El uno es café y el otro es una café.
El café, ¿a qué se refiere esta palabra café con tilde en ahí?
La cafetería.
Perfecto. Y el coffee es la bebida, ¿no es cierto? Café is the place and the coffee is the drink. That is the difference between both. Now, pay attention to the audio. Vamos a poner atención al audio una vez que ya hemos leído, pues, y sabemos los tips de los que nos está hablando. Ahora, usted va a poner un visto. Mientras sigue escuchando el audio, pues, se va a referir a uno de estos tips. Una pequeña ayuda para ustedes es de que solo dos no van a ir con visto. El resto de todos los otros puntos se va a hablar en la conversación esta, ¿ya? Ok, so pay attention to the audio, be quiet.
Welcome back to Mike in the Morning, the talk show that gets you ready for the day. For those of you just joining us, we're discussing ways to make small talk. Some people find initiating a conversation difficult or even awkward, but it can be easy. Remember to listen carefully to what the other person says and respond accordingly. Here are a few topics you can bring up. Entertainment news, like Lady Gaga's newest CD, sports. Talk about the current rankings and make predictions about the next game, or your perspective on the New York Times weekly bestseller. And food is always a winning subject. You can recommend that new steakhouse you tried last night. Most importantly, just be yourself. If you're relaxed, your conversation will flow more smoothly.
Okay, students, you got a minute in order to respond to this exercise. Tiene un minuto para que pueda responder el ejercicio. For the number two, tip number two, it is being discussed in this audio. ¿Está siendo discutido el número dos en el audio? ¿Sí o no?
Yes.
Excellent. Ismael, number three, yes or no?
No.
That is not correct. Yes. Yamilet Noriega, for the number four, it is being discussed in this topic. ¿Está siendo discutido en el audio?
Yes.
Muy bien. Pinto Isaac, number five, yes or no?
No.
Muy bien, no se discute ese en el audio. Zapata Alexander, number six, yes or no?
Yes.
Muy bien, and finally, Morales Emily, number seven.
Yes.
Muy bien, chicos, entonces, solo el número uno y el número cinco no se discutieron en el audio. Now, quickly, we're going to resolve the task number two. Listen to the three small talks. Read the statements and check the appropriate box, ¿no? Escuche los tres diálogos cortos. Lea las oraciones y ponga un visto en los cuadros apropiados. We have three dialogues, five statements, and after we have to see true, false, or it depends. Perez Emilia, please, can you read the first sentence?
When Hans says, I haven't seen you for 8 months, likely means that Woody is getting old.
Thank you. Number two, Jair Camacho.
Woody's cough is very demanding.
Thank you. Lord Sheila, number three.
In dialogue two, the speakers have just come acquainted.
Number four, Byron Vizcarra.
Asking someone's age is an acceptable conversation start.
Conversation started. Altamirano Helen, number five.
Three, things it's respectful to this.
So we are going to listen to the dialogue number one. Please pay attention. You must to check true, false, or it depends. Are you ready? So let's do it.
Dialogue one. Hey, buddy, I haven't seen you for ages. How have you been?
Pretty good. I've been occupied with work. I'm a reporter now. You know what they say, the news never sleeps.
Yeah, I bet you look forward to your days off.
Definitely. This party is awesome, isn't it, for
For sure. Have you tried the sushi rolls?
Not yet.
You should. They are the best snacks here.
Dialogue two.
What a gorgeous baby. Thank you. She's 3 weeks old. That explains why she is so tiny. What's her name?
Emily.
A pretty name for a pretty baby. Are you two enjoying the sunshine?
Very much. It's a lovely day, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I hope you and Emily have fun on your walk in the park.
Thanks. Have a nice day.
And finally, dialogue three.
Hello.
Hey, Trish. It's Lisa.
Hi, Lisa. What's new?
Well, did you hear the news?
What news? Fill me in.
Rumor has it that Molly and Ryan have split up.
What? They seem to be really compatible.
I know, but I heard that they had a big argument. Molly caught Brian cheating on her, so she dumped him.
Wow, that's crazy.
Depends. I don't know. For me, it's true. Yes, it is true. Number four, Carrera Tatiana. Asking someone's age is an acceptable conversation starter. Tatiana.
Listen.
True, false, or it depends?
True.
No, that is not correct. Lozano Natalia. Number four, true, false, or it depends? Lozano Natalia. No, the correct answer is it depends. And finally, number five, Morales Emily. Trish thinks it is disrespectful to discuss other people's private information. True, false, or
it depends?
No, that is not correct answer. Perez Emilia.
False.
Excellent. False. Y pues eso tenemos nosotros en la página 122. Finalmente va a ver ahí en su libro que tiene dos pequeños cuadritos, ¿no es cierto? Pinto Isaac, please can you read the attack question? Lea, por favor, esto.
A tough question is a statement followed by a short question. It is commonly used to start a conversation and it allows the speakers to make a comment while asking the listeners option at the same time.
Thank you. Entonces tenemos nosotros este pequeño recuadro, ¿no? Y finalmente los ejemplos. This party is awesome, isn't it? Lo que le está preguntando aquí, o sea, aquí, es esta parte, esta fiesta está increíble. ¿No es así? Puede hacerlo de manera negativa y de manera afirmativa. You are in front around here. Tú no estás de por aquí, ¿verdad? O si no, no es así. Aunque aquí, como está en afirmativo, la mejor traducción nos queda ¿verdad? Listo, chicos. Bueno, les voy a tomar lista.